This morning in the buzz, from the high-flying Cirque du Soleil to the low-cut gowns, it's all about the Oscars. This year, the Academy brought back host Billy Crystal. The actor and comedian seemed to fare better than last year's choice of James Franco and Anne Hathaway. But still, many thought his first time back since 2004 could have been a bit more memorable. The big winner of the night was The Artist. The silent film took home the award for Best Picture, Best Actor, and Best Director. Then there was the stunt by actor Sacha Baron Cohen on the red carpet. Cohen arrived as the dictator, saying he was carrying the ashes of Kim Jong-il, then spilled them on Ryan Seacrest. Cohen previously had been banned, but the Academy must have had a change of heart. And of course, it wouldn't be an award show without the wardrobe malfunctions. Many speculated that Jennifer Lopez's low-cut dress was a little too low as she presented an award, but Jennifer Lopez, the stylist, is setting the record straight, saying the proper precautions were in place and the dress fit perfectly. I thought it fit perfectly.
You would. All right, now before we touch upon any of those.
Yes, here we go.
I don't know if you remember, but back when they announced who was up for Best Picture, we each had an envelope and we guessed our own predictions of who was going to win. So let's see if anyone got it right. Dun, 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 dun. Bam! I got it!
I just picked one that had a pretty word.
The Artist.
I had to help.
Oh,
really? Oh, we all had different ones.
Like you had
I had Midnight in Paris. I hadn't seen any of them, and I just thought Paris sounded pretty.
There you go. And you had the help.
I had the help. I was going to do such a dance.
I had The Artist, and here is why. Because the Academy likes movies like this.
They do.
I hate to say it, but, you know, going into it, I'm thinking, I still don't think I'm going to see it.
No. It just doesn't interest me.
Maybe I'll watch a little bit of it. Midnight in Paris, I didn't even see it.
They usually love him.
That's why I picked it. I thought it has Paris, and he directed it. Oh, well.
And I picked that because, you know, before, there was all the hype about the help and everything. But, you know, I think if I knew that, you know, we were talking about last week, how the Academy is a bunch of older folks.
Yeah.
I think I would have picked The Artist.
They like weird movies.
They do like weird movies.
Well, not necessarily weird. I think it says a lot about that movie, to the fact that, you know, you can bring back a very popular genre and have it be as successful as it was. I mean, that was something that's old school Hollywood classic that they did. And apparently went over well.
Did you hear last night, I don't know if you guys were watching any of the red carpet stuff, but someone was asking the actress in The Artist, you know, about the script. And she said, well, the script was only about this big.
It's a silent movie.
It's a silent movie. There really wasn't many words in the movie at all, you know?
Can't beat it. Yeah. Well, of course, everyone was talking about it on Twitter and Facebook last night during the event, weighing in. So we asked everyone on our Facebook page what you thought about last night's awards. And Jay Devani says it was really well done, especially the Cirque show. However, Angelina was scary thin. And why was she standing like a crazy person?
Yes, her leg was protruding
was,
a lot.
Yeah.
I liked the guy that made fun of her, though, when he was accepting the award.
Nick Albany says, I think Billy did great. He had funny and witty jokes, but the audience was weak. 50% of them were uptight, and only 10% even got his humor.
I agree. There should have been more laughter.
Yes, I thought he did
a great job.
And Ash Michelle tells us on Facebook, something was missing. I can't quite put my finger on it. You can weigh in, too, by voting in today's poll. What did you think of the Oscars? Did you think they were fun, entertaining, and fashionable? Did it have its highs and its lows? Or was it too long and a little boring? Well, here's a look at some other topics that are trending online today. We all know that The Artist won big time last night, but the most buzzworthy topic was actually Angelina Jolie's exposed right leg. There were over 3,000 tweets per minute about the enormous slit and the way she stood on stage. Some people are wondering if this could be the new T-Bowing, and they're calling it Angelie-Bowing. Her appendage actually inspired its own Twitter profile, so if you're on Twitter, check out Angie's Right Leg. And talk about teamwork. Check out this viral video that was filmed during the UConn-Syracuse basketball game. The Husky student section performed a giant flash mob. Supposedly, they rehearsed it all within 1 hour. Not too shabby. And you've probably played with your cats and dogs with a laser pointer, but how about a fish? Well, animals love it, and here's a video showing a puffer fish getting in on the action. He's so cute, swimming around his tank. This video is just over a week old, and it has already reached over 250,000 views on YouTube. That is one famous fish.